Okay, there I was just kind of messing around with the concert D flat scale, which is the trumpet's E flat. And in the E flat major, you have three flats, B flat, E flat. Now, depending, the high E flat is second valve, the low E flat on the first line is 2 and 3, and A flat, 2 and 3. So here's the scale. So E flat major. I'm throwing little flips and things in here just because that's a little more interesting for me. If that's messing with you, don't bother doing those. I hope I'm not messing you up too much, but you should be able to figure it out. So there's the E-flat major. Again, if we build on the second degree of the scale, we're going to be doing F Dorian. Okay, this is associated with the 2 chord, so here's F Dorian using the same notes, just starting on going from F to F. Okay. If we go to the 3 chord, say in a 3, 6, 2, 5, 1 progression, the 3 chord is the Phrygian mode, and in this case it's going to be G Phrygian, so here we go. It's a really neat sound to that mode, kind of exotic sounding. Next is the A-flat Lydian, built on the 4, or the 4th degree of the E-flat major scale. Now, again, you can go lower with this one if that's too high for you. There. And now we get to the 5th degree of the E-flat major. And the 5th degree is also known as the Mixolydian, which is associated with the 5 chord or the 5-7 chord. And in music theory, this is usually shown with a V, okay, Roman numeral V for 5, and a little 7 above it. So the 5-7 chord, also known as the dominant. And this pretty much always leads to the 1 chord. So in this case, the 1 chord is E-flat, right? So here's B-flat Mixolydian, or B-flat 7. It's the 5 chord in the key of E-flat. Okay, next up is the C Aeolian. And this is built on the 6th degree of the E-flat major scale. Same exact notes, same key signature, just starting on C. This is the C natural minor. So here it is. Very melancholy, sort of sad feel to the minor. That's used for the 6th chord. Okay, in a 3-6-2-5-1, or a 6-2-5-1, or a 3-6-2-5-1, any of those progressions, which are very, very common, you'd use that mode. Last but not least is the D Locrian, and that's built on the 7th degree of the scale, starts on D, goes from D to D, using the same key as E-flat. Here it is. Now, as before, I'm going to show you the major pentatonic and the relative minor pentatonic and the blues scale that's also associated with the key of E-flat. So, again, the pentatonic is built on the 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. Okay, those degrees of the E-flat major scale sounds like this. Okay, as before, the minor pentatonic is the exact same notes, but it starts on the 6th degree of the scale. So in this case, we're starting on C. So this would be the C minor pentatonic. Same exact notes, just in a different order. Okay, really fun to mess around with these modes or scales or whatever. In fact, when you practice these, I would recommend that. Learn them up and down, learn patterns, and then just sort of let yourself go and improvise and stay in that key, or go out of it if you want, but come back to it if you go outside. A friend of mine used to say, if you go outside, make sure you wipe your feet off before you come back in. You may or may not get that joke. If you play jazz, you probably get it. So that was the minor pentatonic, and there's, of course, a blues scale associated with E-flat major, and a lot of you, if you've been playing trumpet for a while and learning your blues scale, will probably learn this one first. And this blues scale starts on the 6th degree of the E-flat major scale. It's very, very closely related to the E-flat, the C minor pentatonic. There's just one extra note. So here it is. C blues scale. So those are the scales for E flat major. Those are the scales that are associated with it, scales and modes. Have fun. Good luck with your practice.